Hello, I'm about to drive up to Scotland to do some filming for my Cruising the Cut Canals channel, but because I'm going to be up there for a couple of days at least, I'm going in the van, and so I thought I would do a van vlog about the van aspects of the trip. The first thing I did was check the tyre pressures, which I haven't done in a long while. They were a bit low and needed pumping up. And then the trip did not get off to an auspicious start when I got back in the van and turned the engine on. The check engine light came on the dashboard. Well, obviously, the first thing I did was turn the engine off and back on again, hoping it would magically disappear. But no, it was very definitely there. So I popped down the supermarket to get some supplies for the trip and have a little ponder. And the light was still on when I came out of there. So there's a convenient garage near the supermarket, and I popped in on the off chance, said, "Have you got a code reader?" Lo and behold, they had. And there was a little smattering of about five different error codes, all to do with an earth short circuit, which just sounds horrendous to try and track and find. However, the nice man cleared the codes with his magic computer and then turned the engine back on, and it had gone. So he thinks maybe there's a bit of damp on one of the wires or something. We did have very heavy rain last night. The van's been sitting on a slight incline, so perhaps some damp got into something. I've just had a little drive around town and the light hasn't come back on again. So I'm going to carry on and head on up to Scotland. I have got breakdown rescue if something really dramatic happens, but let's hope that was just a random bit of weather causing that problem. Maybe. Let's find out. It was going to be a long trip, starting up the M5 around the west of Birmingham. And then you join the M6, which goes all the way to the border with Scotland. It was, thankfully, a glorious day. About halfway into the trip, I'd planned to take a break for lunch, and this saw me turning off at Junction 36, just before the start of the Lake District.
Exit the roundabout onto A519.
I'd spotted a little place on the map, just off the junction, where I could sit and have a sandwich.
Exit the roundabout onto A65.
A slightly awkward turn in through two fence posts, and this would do nicely.
After 2.5 hours driving, and the journey will take over 5 hours in total, I have decided to take a break, and I looked up in advance where I might stop. And motorway services are unappealing, overpriced places. So although this spot is a bit noisy, it's rather pretty. And so I'm going to have a sandwich and something to drink here, I think.
It was as I sat eating my cheese and staring at the water that I suddenly realised I was next to a canal. I really hadn't appreciated that when I'd planned to stop here. But what canal was it, and why did it come to a halt here by the M6? And then I suddenly remembered. This must be the top end of the Lancaster Canal, which is unrestored and cut three times by the motorway. There are hopes one day to reconnect this bit, but for the moment it sits alone. It's a very pleasant place to stretch your legs in the sun. Lunch over, I climbed back in the van and headed further up the M6. Going up with the Lake District on my left and the Yorkshire Dales and the Pennines on my right, I was rewarded with superb views over lovely undulating hills. At Gretna Green you cross into Scotland and are welcomed with this sign. The road, apparently unchanged, is now marked the A74M and heads in the direction of Glasgow, although halfway along it I would do a 90 degree right turn. Edinburgh would now be my heading, along more minor roads. The very pleasant views continued unabated. With sunny, dry weather, this had been a much more pleasant trip than I'd feared. Inevitably, Google played its merry pranks, taking me on some narrow country lanes. But I was delighted to see the rivers and streams alongside. Finally, I made my destination, a village called Ratho. Down here on the left where that truck is, by the side of a somewhat expensive pub, is a road to the canal and my parking spot for the night.
Your destination is on the left.
As you can tell, I failed to notice the first of the speed bumps. But I'd made it.
I have arrived, after just over 5 hours, at Ratho Canal Basin. Ratho is a small town, village, on the outskirts of Edinburgh. The canal comes through here, as you can possibly see behind me. And for logistical reasons, this is where I need to be this evening, and I'll be taking the bus from here in the morning. There is an organisation called the Seagull Trust, which runs these boats, based here at the basin. They provide trips for people with special needs. It's a charity doing all sorts of good works. One of those good works is they've said I can park here in my camper van overnight. And they're taking part in this canal boat flotilla that is what I've come along to film. And this is the Union Canal that runs from Falkirk to the middle of Edinburgh. I'll be coming along that tomorrow, ending up back here, which is why I'm leaving the van and going into Edinburgh by bus. Tonight's exciting supper, because I don't feel like cooking anything more substantial, beef and carrots from a tin, possibly with a bit of bread or something to mop up the gravy.
You've got to love the invention of tins and cans that have a handle built in to open them. Genius!
Smells all right. Okay, it never looks good when you tip that out of a tin, but...
The pills next to the bread were paracetamol. I had a stonking headache after the drive. Okay, it doesn't look like much, but it actually tasted all right and was just what I needed.
With the meal done, I'm pretty much done for the night. It's only 8 o'clock, but I haven't really got anything else to do. I've had quite a long day with the drive up here, and it will probably be quite a long day tomorrow and again on Saturday. So I think I will just get an early night, maybe read for a bit or something, watch a bit of YouTube. Anyway, good night. Good morning. I've had not a bad night's sleep, slightly to my surprise. I did wonder whether any of the many small flying insects out there would come and bother me during the night. And in fact, it was all fine. The only thing that did bother me during the night was a beeping sound. I thought, oh, here we go. What, the alarm's going off, one of the alarms. Turns out the batteries in the carbon monoxide alarm clearly want replacing after, well, it must be 4 years, so no great surprise there. So I need to get a new set of AAA batteries for that alarm. It's time now for some breakfast. It's a lovely sunny day. The forecast said today was going to be overcast and rainy, but it's beautiful. The plan for today is to go to Edinburgh by bus. I think it's two buses, actually. It's so long since I've used a bus, I can't remember how they work. There's different bus companies involved, I think. I don't know if I can get one ticket or have to go with separate tickets or whatever. We'll find out. And then come back on a canal boat, because there's a procession coming from Edinburgh, Lochrin Basin, I think it is, to here. So I'll be back here, and then I'm going to get in the van and go over to Falkirk, where tomorrow another procession of boats is going to go from Falkirk to Linlithgow, while simultaneously the one that ended here will be going from here to Linlithgow. So by tomorrow night, they all end up at Linlithgow. So that's the canal filming I'm doing, and that will be over on the Canal Channel. For now, I've got a lovely day. A very suspicious-looking security guard wandered by, peering at me, wondering what I was doing, but I do have permission to be here, so that's okay. And I don't think the boats leave Edinburgh until about 12:30, so I've got plenty of time. It's not even 9 o'clock now. And Edinburgh's just a mile or two that way.
Walking up from the Seagull Trust Basin to the road, and there should be a bus stop up here, so I'm told. And indeed, there is a bus stop. But will there be a bus? Whether you are a fan of the monarchy or not, that is rather sweet.
on top of the post box. Isn't that great?
The bus duly arrived on time and accepted a card payment to my relief, as I'd got no cash. I rather like buses. They're a good way to see places that you just can't do when driving. Bus 1 took me just to a main road, whereupon I needed to catch bus 2 into the heart of the city. As luck would have it, that bus turned up within minutes. More of a luxury coach than a bus, and a top deck meant a great view out. Soon enough, I disembarked in Edinburgh and walked towards Lochrin Basin, taking snaps as I went. Suddenly, peering between two buildings on the other side of the road, I spotted what was surely a narrowboat, and that could only mean I was in the right place. Yes, Lochrin Basin. There was a cafe boat moored there, so I ordered a milky coffee and had a blueberry muffin, my favourite. Then I joined the boats for the rest of the day.
As you can see, I'm now back at the van. It's 6:20 in the evening. It's a little bit damp overhead, and I shall now drive to Falkirk, ready for tomorrow's boat trip.
Falkirk was about half an hour away, mostly by motorway, the M9 nice and clear for the trip. I'd seen pictures of the Falkirk wheel, of course, but when you actually get there and pull up to the thing, it's really more spectacular than I expected.
I am parked up. There's the only car in the entire car park here, though there are some in the lower car parks. But this is the one that overlooks the wheel itself.
The wheel, if you're unaware, is a giant rotating lift that transfers boats from the Union Canal down to the Forth and Clyde Canal below, and vice versa. So, to get your bearings, here's the Forth and Clyde, and you go from there into this lock, which brings you into the basin below the wheel. Then your boat goes into a caisson at the wheel and is rotated up by 24 metres, that's 79 feet.
Here's a canal basin, and here's the mighty wheel that takes boats up to the canal up that hill.
And here are some facts and figures about it.
And this will be my chariot for tomorrow, the Bar Seagull, run by the Seagull Trust. It's time to cook some food, and tonight's gourmet extravaganza is chicken in white sauce with rice. Chicken in white sauce out of a tin, of course.
Just as I settled, another campervan had the temerity to park in my car park. How dare they? Never mind, I fed myself this delicious treat and went to bed.
There it is in daylight. It is really a magnificent structure. More crucially at the moment, however, at the bottom down there in a building are boaters' facilities, including showers. So I'm going to make use of those.
Morning.
There's the wheel, there's the little basin, and behind this building it's showers.
You need a British Waterways key to unlock these, but you can borrow one as part of the fee for camping here overnight.
Nice facilities, you've got a sink, a mirror, there's the shower, all nice and clean.
Well, I feel better for that, fully refreshed, ready for the day ahead.
You can see why there had to be 11 locks here for the canal before they built the wheel. Back at the van, breakfast was served.
While it is quiet in terms of people, it's not even 9 o'clock yet, I think I'll just quickly fling the drone up and get some shots of the wheel.
It's very space age, like something from a Buck Rogers set. I used to like Buck Rogers. That's the end of the Union Canal, and boats come along into those giant tubs, and then it rotates. My day on the boats was largely like this. At the end of it all, I got a train back to Falkirk from Linlithgow. I rather like this flower pot construction made from, I'm guessing they were whiskey barrels, since we're in Scotland. Once back at Falkirk, there was a bus which goes directly to the wheel, rather helpfully.
And that is it. The Scotland trip is coming to an end. Now there's just the little matter of driving all the way home again.
The first thing I needed was to refuel. And for any of my American viewers who think your fuel prices are too high, try this when filling up with diesel. And that's at a relatively cheap supermarket filling station. It's nearly all motorway back home from Falkirk, starting with the M80. But unlike the journey up, this time the heavens opened. Although even in rain, the hills have a certain beauty. Just before I finish, does anyone know why Lancaster Services has what looks like an airport control tower as part of the building? It's coming up on the right. It's like Seattle's Space Needle if it was a lot shorter. But why? Cheerio.